Okay, we will very good morning. We will wait for 1 minute, then we will start our session. Okay, so let's start our session. So previously, in the previous lecture, we will discuss about the introduction, some few parts or few portion of the Jet transformation, what the Jet transformation is and how the Jet transformation that will be differentiate with the Laplace transformation, some introductory part, what will be the difference between the Laplace transformation and the Fourier transformation, depending upon the differential functions. Depending on that, we will derive the equation in a Laplace domain as well as in the Fourier domain. In the Z transformation domain. Right. So today we will discuss in a brief that how the signals that will generate, what are the different signals that will be introduced in the Jet transformation methods. So that thing we will discuss today. So what will be the in which signals the Jet transformation will be applied, okay, which supposed to be in a continuous time signal, either it should be the sample signal or in a number sequence. In each and every cases, how the Jet transformation that will applied, okay, how the Jet transformation is deal, okay, so that thing we will discuss. So occasionally we will told that the sample signal, okay, and as well as the number sequence that is occasionally used for introduction of a Jet transformation. Rather, we are mainly using the continuous time signal for implementing the Jet transformation, right? So first we have to before starting the Jet transformation, we have to understand the what the different type of signals that we will consider in the Jet transformation, right? So we have a, as because we are taught about the digital control system, so there must have a discrete time signals, right? So discrete times means digital time signals, right? So that should be on 0101 like this. So discrete time signals that is taken into consideration for Jet transformational operational methods, right? So before starting that, we have to understand what are the different signals that will be involved in the Jet transformation, and using this Jet transformation, how we can change this particular sampled signal or any such kind of continuous signal to my other signals. Okay, so that thing we will discuss today, right? So I will directly go to my share section so that you will able to see. So is my screen is visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So previously we will discuss. So these are my objective, that means introductory part of a Jet transformation and the some definition. I already discussed what the Jet transformation is, okay, so jet transformation is nothing but a for the conversion of a discrete time signals into a complex variable frequency domain. Okay, whereas if I differentiate the jet transformation having using a Laplace transformation is undertaken into consideration for only in a continuous time domain, but in the jet transformation that will taken into consideration for the complex variable frequency domain. That means the jet transformation is a one type of method which will convert the discrete time domain signals, okay, into a complex variable frequency domain. So before starting the jet transformation, you need to understand what the discrete time domain signal is, right? What are the different discrete time signals that will be taken into consideration in the field of jet transformation, right? So what does it mean actually? As I will told you that someone has, I think that. So as I will told you in the previous lecture yesterday, as I will told you that the jet transformation is used to take a discrete time domain signals into a complex variable frequency domain. Okay, so before starting the jet transformation, we need to understand what the discrete time domain signal is. Discrete time domain signal. What are the different example that will be involved in the discrete time domain signals? Okay, what will be the behavior of the discrete time domain signals? Okay, so that thing we will discuss today. Okay, and after that, this particular digital time domain signal that will convert it in a complex variable frequency domain using the transformation, we will come in a latter. Okay, first you need to understand what will be my discrete time domain signal is, right? So first we have to discuss about the discrete time domain signal. Time domain signal. What is actually mean? Okay. So actually this discrete time signals that will arise supposed to be if any such kind of system that will involves a sampling operation. Okay. Of a continuous time signals. Okay. So if we are considering the continuous time signal, this will be like this. Okay, as I will already told, this will be my continuous time signal. Okay, which will be analog in nature, whereas we can considering this will be my T, and supposed to be this will be my output like that. Okay, and this will be my zero. So discrete time domain signal is actually arise if the system that will involve the sampling operation of a continuous, that means we can sample, that means discrete time signal, we can sample the continuous time signal, to a discrete time signal using the jet transformational methods, right? So the sampled signal, so what do you mean by the sampled signal? That means whenever we have to sample the continuous time signal to a discrete time signals, means now supposed to be, if I considering this supposed to be like this, so this will be my discrete data for a certain interval of the time. Okay, so for the certain intervals of a time. Okay, so we are getting some data that will be my discrete data. Okay, and this will be my continuous signals, right? Or we can say that it can be considered as like this, supposed to be this is my continuous signal, and having there we have supposed to be in this part we have so this will be my discrete data having a different time interval, whereas T actually called as a time periods, right? So we can say that the sampled signal is actually what? Sampled signal example supposed to be sampled signal. Okay, supposed to be, if I will take it into consideration, supposed to be x0, right? X of t, okay, x of 2t, like this. So this will be my sampled signal, like this. So t will be my time interval, right? So x of 0 in this case, then x of t, then x of 2t, x of 3t, dot 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 dot, x of nt, or we can say that the x of kt. Okay, k is nothing but a number sequence, or we can say that that will involve any such kind of sampling operation. So that thing, so sampled signal, if you will consider, this will be my sample one sampling signal, this will be my another sample signal, and this will be my another sample signal. Okay, so if the sample signal will be like that, where t is my sampling period, so t is my sampling period, right? So such a sequence, so this will be my sequence type of structures. Okay, so such a sequence of a values that will arise during the sampling operation is usually, so this type of sequence means, if the sequence will be like this, supposed to be x of 0, x of t, x of kt, 2t, like this, x of 3t, okay, dot 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 dot, nt, x of nt. So this particular sequence of values, so this is the values of a particular time interval, right? So such a sequence of that particular value that will arising when the sampling operation is happened, that is usually written as, this particular sequence is actually written as x of kt, right? So if the system that will involve the iterative process carried out by the digital, because as we will discuss in the module 1, that digital computer is actually nothing but a what? It's a digital controller. So we are getting the output from the digital controller is a digital data, discrete digital data. Okay, so if the system that will involve any such kind of iterative process that will be carried out by the digital computer or the digital controller, then we can say that the signal that will involve in a number sequence, because whatever the data that will coming from the digital controller, okay, whatever the output we are coming that will carried out from the digital computer, that will involve the signal like a number sequence. Number sequence means, suppose 0, 1, like this. Okay, so this will be my number sequence. Okay, so if the system that will involve a iterative process that will be carried out in a digital controller or the digital computer. So that particular signal that will involves in a number sequence. So the number sequence, if I consider the number sequence, so this is the another type of sequence. Okay, so if I consider the number sequence, so the number sequence will be like this, supposed to be the x of 0, okay, x of 1, x of 2, like this. Okay, so the sequence of number, so this particular type of sequence of number, we can written as x of small k, right? So this particular sequence we can written as x of kt. Okay, and this particular type of sequence, number sequence, this is actually my number sequence, that will be written as my x of k. Okay, where the k is actually, in both the cases, k is actually nothing but a, the, it k is actually indicates the order in which the number occurs in a sequence. That means the order of the number sequence. much, right? So the order of the number sequence that will be considered as a key, right? So in that cases where we can say that, for an example, if we will consider this will be my number sequence x0, x1, x2. So although x of k, this will be considered as my number sequence, as because this will be my number sequence. So x of k, it will be considered as a number sequence, and x of kt will be considered as a iterative process sequence. Is iterative signal process sequence, or x of kt will be considered as a iterative process number sequence. Both the sequence that will be arise due to my digital controller, because the sampling operation that will happen in the digital controller. Okay, so we can say that for the consideration of the sampled signal, like a x of t, right? So x of t, when the sampling period t, that can be considered as a 1 second. Okay, so it can be considered, we can say that it can be considered as a sampled signal of x of t, okay, when the sampling period will be defined as a t s 1 second, right? So when t is equal to 1, then we are getting the values of x of t, right? So if the values of the sampling period that will increasing, then we are getting, so suppose the sampling period at that 2, then x of 2t. Okay, so 2 is actually, so if the t is equal to 3, then it will be considered as x of 3t, like this. So if that will be considered t is equal to n, okay, then it will be considered as x of nt, or we can say that x of small kt, okay, where we can told you k is actually what? K is actually the order of the sequence of number, okay. So order means, so this will be my order, okay, 2, 3, 4, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, like this, okay. So this will be my sequence of a numbers, okay. So where k is actually nothing but the number that will occur, that means order of the number that will occur in a particular sequence, right? So we can say that the J transformation is applied in the continuous time signal, which will be considered as a x of t, okay. So we can say that the J transformation is applied to the continuous time signal. Continuous time signal, which can be treated as x of t, okay, x of t sampled signal. So the J transformation that will apply to the sampled signal okay, which will be defined as x of small kt, okay, and the J transformation that will apply to the number sequence which will be considered as a x of small k, right? So all those signals that we can apply the J transformation, whether it should be the continuous time signal, whether it should be the sample signal, or whether it should be the number sequence, right? So whatever the signal is, we can apply the J transformation each and every signals, right? Whatever the signal is. Suppose in a particular process, we have considering the continuous time signal, then we are applied the continuous time signal supposed to be XC, XT. So we have to apply the Z transformation of X of T, right? Write this, okay? So we have to apply the Z transformation of X of KT, like this. X of KT like this, okay? So we have to apply the Z transformation of X of small k. So all this Z transformation that will apply in each and every signals, okay? So there must have a different values, okay? So they must have a different, okay, 1 second, I have a call. Hello, 1 second. Yes, I have an important call. Hello. ओह अच्छा अच्छा हम नहीं भेज पाए थे एक्चुअली क्या है कि उसमें अभी ना थोड़ा दिक्कत है ठीक है उस अकाउंट में ठीक है तो तुम एक काम कर सकते हो तुम्हारा कौन सा मोड में देने से सुविधा होगा तुम्हारा अच्छा SBI नेट में तुम्हारा वो जो SBI का लिंक है फोन पे या गूगल पे से हाँ हाँ पे है तो इसी नंबर पे मेरा फोन पे अकाउंट नंबर है ठीक है तो तुम एक काम करो मेरे अकाउंट में भेज दो आई विल ट्रांसफर द मनी टू द कॉलेज अदर अकाउंट बिकॉज दैट विल नॉट बीन एक्टिव टिल रिसेंटली इट विल बी इनएक्टिव राइट नाउ ओके हाँ यही नंबर पे तुम हमको भेजना ठीक है जितना अमाउंट तुम भेज बोले हो एडमिन में एडमिन सेक्शन में ठीक है उसका जो एक ठो ट्रांजैक्शन आईडी मिलेगा उस ट्रांजैक्शन आईडी को ठीक है तुमको हमको एक ठो मेल करना है और वहाँ पे अभय सर को जो एडमिन हेड है एडमिन रिप्रेजेंटेटिव है उसको सर को अटैच करके मेल करना है ठीक है मेल मतलब एक ठो ट्रांजैक्शन आईडी मिलेगा ना तुम अगर फोन पे या गूगल पे कुछ भी करोगे ठीक है हाँ उसका एक्नॉलेजमेंट को मेल करना है हमको CC में अभय सर को रख के ठीक है हाँ कॉलेज का मेल आईडी हम तुमको दे रहे हैं ठीक है उसमें तुमको सेंड कर देना है जो तुम्हारा जो ट्रांजैक्शन आईडी है ठीक है हाँ वो जो यही नंबर पे मेरा नंबर ये है ठीक है इसी नंबर पे तुम फोन पे कर देना ठीक है ओके और वो जो ट्रांजैक्शन फोन पे कर वो तुम एक तो स्क्रीनशॉट आएगा ना ट्रांजैक्शन आईडी आएगा ना तो उसको मेल कर देना हम ठीक है हमको भी करना और अभय सर को भी करना जो मेल आईडी तुमको देंगे हम ठीक है ओके ठीक ठीक हाँ यस कहाँ पे थे हम लोग हेलो दीपक कहाँ पे थे हम लोग हेलो हाँ कहाँ पे थे हम लोग कौन से जगह में पर आ रहे थे दैट मीन्स दिस वन ईच एंड एवरी सिग्नल दैट वी आर अप्लाइड ओके सम नॉइज इज देयर आई थिंक सो यू हैव टू स्विच ऑफ योर नॉइज So what we can say that if we have a different kind of signal, so each and every signal we can apply the Z transformation, right? Depending upon what my signal is, either it should be the continuous time signal, whether it should be the sample signal, and whether it should be the number sequence. Okay, so different signals have a different property, right? So in case of a sample signal, how can we define? In case of a number sequence, how the signals that will define, we had already told, if it will be the continuous time signal, the continuous time signal that will taken into consideration for X of T, right? X of T, okay? So, whatever the signal is, we can apply the Z transformation, right? So, we can say that the Z transformation method is actually nothing but a operational method that will be very much powerful when working in a discrete time system, right? So keep in mind these things always. Using the Z transformation, we can use the different methods. So that is why the Z transformational methods, which will be very much powerful when we are implementing in the MATLAB operation or whatever the field is. Okay, so that using the Z transformation, we can convert any such kind of signals to a particular signal. Okay, so that is why the Z transformational method is one such kind of operational method that will be very much powerful when it will working in a discrete time system, right? Okay, so in that content, we can say that we can define the Z transformation of the time function. So we can define the Z transformation either in a time domain, okay, or either in a time function or in a number sequence, right? So if we will consider that the Z transformation as a time function, okay, so if we will consider the Z transformation as a time function, so suppose if we considered the Z transformation in time as a time function, or if we applied the Z transformation in a time domain, so we can apply it in both the domain. One is a time domain, another one is a number sequence. The number sequence that will be carried out in a S domain, right? Okay, or the frequency domain. Okay, because the main operation of the Z transformation is actually for the conversion from the time domain to the conversion from the complex frequency domain. As I will told you in the previous lecture, that the Z transformation is actually nothing but a conversion from the discrete time domain signals into a complex variable frequency domain. So first we have to apply the Z transformation to the discrete time domain signals. So what my time function is, so we have to apply the time domain. First we have to apply the Z transformation in the time domain, then we will convert this time domain function to the frequency, complex frequency domain, right? So if we will consider the time function supposed to be considering as a xt, okay, so if you consider the Z transformation of a time function supposed to be my x of t, okay, then we will consider only, then we can consider only the sampled value of xc. Okay, so if we are applied the Z transformation in a time function, that means we can only consider, we can only consider the sampled value of x of t. Okay, sampled value of x of t. That means when we are applied the Z transformation to a particular time function or in a particular time domain signals, okay, that means we can, that particular signal or the time domain functional signal that will be already been converted into a sampled signal. Okay, so if we are applied already the Z transformation, that means we will taken into consideration only the sampled values of xt, okay, not a actual value of xt. Okay, so after the application of the Z transformation to a particular time signals, okay, so that particular sample time signals that will taken into consideration in the Z transformation. Keep in mind these things. That is, so supposed to be sampled values of xt means, what does it mean by the sampled values of xt? Sample values of xt means supposed to be my x0, x of t, okay, x of 2t, okay, like this. So that particular sampled value where applied the Z transformation, where we can say that the t is my sampling period. Okay, again you have to remind that the Z transformation of the time function xt, okay, keep in mind these things always. The Z transformation of a time function, keep keep remind these things, because whenever we have an application part, you need to know these things. Otherwise, you cannot be illustrated the sequence, right? So keep remind these things always. The jet transformation of a time function xt, of a time function xt, where we can say that t is your non-negative, t is your non-negative sequence, or we can say that the of a sequence of a value of x of kt. Okay, the sequence of a value of x of kt. Okay, where that means x of kt is actually what? Which type of signals? X of kt is actually my sampled signal. That means we are applied the Z transformation to the sampled signal, right? So whatever my signals is, so we can apply the Z transformation to a sampled values of the signal x of kt, where k is actually, where we can say that k takes 0 or positive integer, 0 or positive integers, and the t, the capital T, is my sampling period. Okay, so either k should be 0 taken into consideration when we are applied the Z transformation to the x of kt, that means sampled signal. Either we can consider taken as a 0, or it should be the positive integer. That means we are taken into consideration Z value is always positive, right? Not supposed to be if we consider x of 0, okay? If we will consider x of 2, x of 3 like this, we cannot consider x of minus 2, x of minus 3. When we can take into consideration the negative integer in an inverse Z transformation, not the Z transformation, right? In case of the inverse Z transformation, supposed to be the Z transformation of e to the power minus alpha t, like this. So if we will converting the inverse Z transformational method, then only we will considering the negative integers, okay? But in case of a only Z transformation, whenever we have applied the Z transformation to the particular sequence of a value like a x of kt, okay, then we can consider k as a 0, or the k must have a positive integer, and t is already, you know, that t is actually my sampling period, right? Okay, so if we will consider some equations like that, okay, suppose if we will consider some equation, okay, how can we define one Z transformational equation? Okay, so the equation can be defined in a such a way, in a Z transformation equation that can be defined, in Z transformation, in Z transform, how it will be look like? The capital X of J supposed to be, that will be taken into Z transformation of, the Z transformation of X of T. That means we are giving the, applied the Z transformation to the continuous signal, right? Continuous time domain, right? So that is equals to the Z transformation of, same as X of small kt, right? So that is equals to, my summation of k is equal to 0 to infinity, always in a positive integers, as I will told you. Okay, so the x of kt into z to the power minus k, okay, and the z to the power minus k, what is it actually that? Okay, can anyone told? Because the z transformation for a particular signal or the particular time signal, okay, that can be defined as a x of j, okay. So that will be my definition, x of j. It can be defined as a x of j, okay, or the notation, okay. We can say that it's a notation of a Z transformation, notation of Z transformation, if the Z transformation is applied in a sampled signal. Okay, so we can apply the Z transformation of x of t, although we can write like this. Okay, so x of j, okay, although the Z transformation for the applied voltage of a sampled signal, okay, applied on a sampled signal, we can note it in a like this, okay, or we can note it like this. So the equation should be like this. So what do you mean by the Z of minus k? Can anyone told? What do you mean by the Z of minus k? Where it is come? Can anyone told? Okay, so think about it. Okay, think about it. So if we will consider this equation like this, so supposed to be the x of j that is equals to the summation of k is equal to 0 to infinity having a positive integer x of kt into z to the power minus k. Okay, so that is my equations. Okay, so that is my significance using the sample data time signals. That means we have applied the Z transformation to a particular signal. Obviously, it should be the sampled signal, right? So for a sequence of a number, if we will consider for a sequence of number that can be defined as x of small k. Okay, so if I applied the Z transformation of x of k, if I applied the Z transformation, right, so that can be defined if we will consider the sequence of number. And if I am applied the Z transformation for the sequence of number, then it should be look like x of j that is equals to the Z transformation of x of k. Okay, so that is equals to summation of k is equal to 0 to infinity x of k into z to the base minus k. Okay, so that is the another equation if we are applied the Z transformation to the sequence of a number. The sequence of a number that will be defined as a x of k. That means sequence of a number means, that means x of 0, x of 1, x of 2, like this. Okay, and for the sample signal x of kt, that sequence will be what? X of 0, x of what? Bolo, kya likhe the? This sequence x of t, right? So x of t, that means 1t, x of 2t, like this. That means x of kt, like this. Okay, so that is why, so that will be the sequence for the x of kt, that means the sample signal, right? So x of 3t, 4t, like that, up to x of nt. Okay, so that will be the sampled signal sequence, right? And that sequence, that will be by the sequence of number, and both are applied in a digital controller, that both are giving the output of a from the digital controller. Okay, so we are applying the Z transformation in both the cases. So if we are applied the Z transformation for the sampled signal, so the equation should be like this. If we are applied the Z transformation in a sequence of a number, okay, then we can the equation should be like this. Suppose this will be my equation 1 and this will be my equation 2. Okay, so using this equation 1 and the equation 2, we can again apply the Z transformation that will be defined in a equation 1 and equation 2 that will be referred, then we can apply the one-sided J transformation, right? So one-sided J transformation is what? Can anyone told one-sided J transformation is actually what? So due to this one-sided J transformation, this Z of minus K that will be taken into consideration. How this will become? Can anyone told? Can anyone told?
The complex variable.
Complex variable. Complex variable that will taken into consideration for the inverse transformation. Inverse J transformation. Inverse Laplace transformation. That means that will be considered as a X of J. Right. So X of J when J inverse. Inverse Laplace transformation. Okay. So this will be actually nothing but a integer value. Okay, for the particular equation or the particular J transformation. Okay, so Z of K it either should be an integer value or it should be having a constant value, right? Whereas I can told you that the Z of minus K, the K is defined actually what? The order of the numbers, the sequence of a numbers. So the sequence of a number that should be in a integer value. So we can say if I considering the J transformation must have a either 0 or it should be the positive integer value. So it must be either Z to the base 0, Z to the base 1, Z to the base 2, Z to the base 3 like this. So up to Z to the base n. Okay. So this will be Z to the base minus k is actually nothing but a integer value that will be depends upon my J transformation. Okay, it may not be there or it may be there depending upon what my sample is or how we can apply the J transformation. Depending upon that, my integer value which will be defined as my Z of minus k that will be taken into consideration. Right. So in a chart we have, I already told you there is a chart. Can you find the chart in the Google? Of a J transformational equation, that means the formula. Can you find anyone in the Google? So read this particular sequence. Suppose is type ka ek to, I think is type ka ek to tumhara ye hoga, kya bolte hai, table hoga. Like this, suppose yahan pe x of z supposed to be x of s, okay, then x of t, that means the continuous time signal, then you have a x of kt, or we can say that the what will be the x of k, okay, that means x of kt is a sampled signal, x of k is my what, it's a sequence of a number, and x of t is my continuous signal. So this type of table, okay, and after this what will be my J transformation, x of j, that means J transformation of this particular sample. Okay, so if this particular sequence of a number that will taken into consideration. So if the sequence is 1 by s, so what will be my Z transformation? Okay, so that will be there. Okay, so there should be, I think it should be 1 minus Z inverse like this. Okay, so what will be my 1 by supposed to be s plus a? Okay, a is actually nothing but a, if you will consider 1 by s plus 2, s plus 1 like this. So then my Z transformation is 1 by 1 minus e to the base minus at into Z inverse like this. So this type of formula that you can, that before going to the application part, okay, of a Z transformation, you need to recapitulate all those equations. Okay, so in the XT domain, it should, if it is a in a continuous time signal, so for that cases, if we have a sample type of data will be like this, then it will comes like a e to the base minus alpha t. Okay, in case of a continuous time signal, but in case of a sampled signal, it should be e to the base minus k alpha t. Okay, like that. Okay, so if it will be my 1 by s, so for that cases it will be considered as the function of 1, okay, or it should be considered as a function of k, like this. Okay, so you keep remind these things. I will display the total equation chart in the next class, okay, so that you will understand ki how this if we have a sample data like this, how we can convert this one as a J transformation. Okay, this is actually the formula. Okay, we are implementing this formula to a particular differential equation, as simple as that. Okay, that means J transformation, if you understand the J transformation, that is very simple. Okay, that means we have a one differential equation, or we have a number sequence, or we have a one sampled signal. We are applied the J transformation of a particular signal depending upon what behavior of my sample data is. Okay, as simple as that. Okay, depending upon my sample data, what will be the my different formula that will be for, supposed to be in case of a continuous time signal, what if this type of signals will be there, what will be my continuous time data, what will be my sample data, and what will be my J transformation, like this. Okay, so I told you in the next class, okay, I briefly discuss the two equations, because we are applying the J transformation in the sampled signal and we are applying the J transformation in the sequence of a number. Okay, so that thing we are discuss elaborately in the next class, and also I will discuss the chart, okay, the whole chart, okay, how it will come. Is that clear? Okay, any question? Ritesh?
Yes, sir.
Any question?
No, sir.
Okay. Pooja? Pooja chala gaya hai. Akshay?
Yes,
sir. Is there any question? Okay, fine. So I think we will stop because you have another class, I think.
Hello, sir.
हाँ, yes, बोलो बोलो
सर. मॉड्यूल 1 से पूछना था कि A to B कन्वर्टर में सक्सेसिव एप्रोक्सिमेशन टाइप है, इंटीग्रेटेड टाइप है, काउंटर टाइप है, पैरेलल टाइप है, इसमें से हम लोग को सिर्फ सक्सेसिव एप्रोक्सिमेशन टाइप ही पढ़ना है क्या?
हाँ, सक्सेसिव एप्रोक्सिमेशन टाइप ऑफ, यानी कि चारों, देखो जो चार्ट तुम्हारा टाइप ऑफ कन्वर्टर है ना, उसमें सक्सेसिव एप्रोक्सिमेशन टाइप ऑफ कन्वर्टर्स जो है वो फास्टर ऑपरेशन है. सो ड्यू टू द फास्टर ऑपरेशन वी विल नॉर्मली यूज द फर्स्ट वन, ओके, रादर देन यूजिंग द थर्ड थ्री. आदत जो थ्री है उसको हम यूज करते हैं, लेकिन डिपेंडिंग अपॉन माई प्रोसेस बिहेवियर. Okay, so normally mainly we will use the successive approximation type of D2A converter in each and every industries. Okay, wherever we, that particular D2A converter is applied. Is that clear? यानी कि जहाँ पे, यानी कि faster operation है बोल के, faster operation है बोल के, वहाँ पे हम लोग successive approximation type of D2A converter ही use करते हैं generally. But वो काउंटर टाइप ऑफ ए टाइप भी यूज कर सकते हैं, लेकिन ऑपरेशन थोड़ा स्लो होगा, सो दैट्स व्हाई वी कैन नॉट यूज.
सर, मॉडल 1 में उसका ब्रीफ में ये सब पढ़ना है कि नहीं, इंटीग्रेटिंग टाइप
नहीं, इंटीग्रेटिंग वो तीन चीज पढ़ना नहीं है, काउंटर इंटीग्रेटिंग टाइप पढ़ना नहीं, ओनली सक्सेसिव एप्रोक्सीमेशन टाइप ऑफ कन्वर्टर का, D2A कन्वर्टर का जो तुम लोगों को दिखा दिए थे, जो ऑपरेशनल मेथड एंड एज वेल एज द डायग्राम using weighted register and using the R2 2R ladder. पढ़ाए थे ना, ठीक है.
तो वो सर तो D2A है ना.
हाँ, D2A.
वो तो सर D2A में दो टाइप का है.
हाँ,
वो तो D2A में दो टाइप का है, एक है ladder वाला और एक है weighted register.
हाँ, weighted register, yes.
तो वो दोनों तो मतलब,
हाँ वो दोनों पढ़ना है, लेकिन तुमको जो ये है क्या बोलते हैं, सिर्फ successive approximation type of D2A converter ही पढ़ना है, ठीक है. ठीक है, नाउ वी विल स्टॉप द सेशन फॉर टुडे. वी विल अगेन डिस्कस आई थिंक इन द नेक्स्ट वीक. ओके, सो थैंक यू, वी विल स्टॉप द सेशन. थैंक यू. सो एवरीवन आई रिक्वेस्टेड टू लीव.